Hey, Jennii from Tye-Dyed Iguana here. I'm here to talk to you guys today about lighting, and more specifically UVB. I wanted to show you how we test our UVB to make sure our animals are nice and healthy. So, let's get to it. So what we have right here is our baby Chinese water dragons. We'll be checking their UVB. All right, so what I'm doing here is I took the lid off so obviously I can get my hand in there, but you also want to put the lid back on. So let's go ahead and check. We'll use our trusty radiometer. And so what we're doing is we're using the measurement through the screen is the measurement that we want. And as you can see right here, right about where they're supposed to be basking, like this stick here, directly underneath the light bulb, it's ringing at about, there we go, about 83, 84, up to 90. So you can see it kind of moves even though, but make sure you have your screen on because that is your true reading and that's what your reptile will be receiving. Watch this, if I take out this lid, see how much of a big difference that makes. So here we have our red foot tortoise. It's a tropical tortoise. We'll be checking their UVB. The minimum for a tropical is 25-20. So let's go ahead and test it. Now usually this right here, mercury vapor, is our UVB bulb. This T5 right here is also our
UVB.
Good lord. What video am I doing? So we'll be testing not just the mercury vapor bulb, but also the strip light as well. So the tortoise could get his UVB right there. So instead of setting it right there, because you'll get a very inaccurate reading, like that 80 right there you're seeing. So what we'll do is we'll actually remove. There he is. And put it to where he would be sitting, which would be about this level. So now you can see it's a much different reading, even though it was by like 2 inches, however much that is. But yeah, so, but it's reading at about 55, 60-ish, and he's good for quite some time. So this is one of our desert tanks, or our red Niger uromastix. We're gonna check their UVB. Since they are a desert species, they actually require a higher microwatts. UVB. So what we'll do is again, keep your screen lid on, and if you want to scooch around. So this is a little too high, not the reading, but where I'm sitting at, because you can see the lizard sitting slow, or the lizard is sitting lower. So what you want to do at that point is you want to, sorry buddy. And we'll be just moving you for half a second. There you go. And remember where they were kind of sitting? So you want to take the true reading of where they would be. So it'd be right about there. So you can see theirs is reading at about 66, 67, you know, something like that. So it's getting close to being bad, but it's not quite there yet, so it's probably good for another month or two. So minimum range for a desert animal would be 45. Once it hits that, you want to replace your light bulb. So you saw how I checked our UVB bulbs and how to measure them and all that good stuff. Now I know not everybody has one of these bad boys, these radiometers, because it can be a little pricey. But if you come to the Tye-Dyed Iguana, we'll be more than happy to check your bulbs for free. So, yeah. So this right here is our mercury vapor bulb. It's an all-in-one. It has UVA, which is heat, and UVB, which is the radiation that we're testing. So your typical mercury vapor bulb will usually last you about 12 to 14 months, but it's always good to get it tested every 3 to 6 months. We usually say every 3 months just to make sure on the safe side. So another one of your UVB lights that you could use, it's called T5. They are like a bar light, and you can kind of see it right here. Let me lift this up. Mm-hmm. It's this part right here. Mm-hmm. And then we'll go ahead and check that. I'll show you, it's the same thing. Check right where they would usually bask. You can see it's pretty consistent across, so So this right here is your strip bulb, and just like the mercury vapor, it has a life expectancy of about a year, but 12 to 14 months is, you know, average. Again, you always want to keep testing it every 3 to 6 months just to make sure it's outputting the correct radiation. So this is another one of our UVBs. This right here is a curly bulb. I'm blanking. It's a
compact fluorescent.
Thank you. I was like, CFL, I don't remember what it stands for. Curly something. So this is another one of our bulbs. It's a CFL. I don't know if it's probably hard to see with the camera. Let me turn it off, but it's one of your curly Q ones right there. Now, these aren't quite as powerful as the T5 or the mercury vapor, but they don't last as long, but they're still good. They still output UVB, so we'll go ahead and test it just to show you. So your CFL usually lasts about 6 months, but again, you just want to test it every 3 to 6 months, but if it only lasts 6 months, then it's a one-time use, right? So let's go ahead and test it. So they would usually be sitting right here. So I'm just going to take it and just kind of squeeze it on in there. And you can see right there, it's reading about 60, 55. So it's still good for just maybe a couple more months. So here at Tye-Dyed Iguana, we actually do a monthly UVB check. So that's what I'll be doing today. Let's go. Oh, I'm so sorry. You would be sitting about here. So yeah, you're still good. Do right here. So that's it's getting that minimum. So this bulb right here, even though I'm not completely directly underneath it, but the bulb's getting old, so we're probably gonna have to be exchanging it out soon. Has 3 mercury vapors, but we still gotta check each one of them. That one's okay. That one's very good. That one's
very good. So you can tell which one is older by where it was lowest. Mm-hmm. So the one that gave out the lowest is the oldest bulb. Yeah.
So if you do end up checking your UVBs, make sure that you leave your light on, or your UVB bulb on, for at least 15 minutes, because it actually takes a while for the radiation to the output, essentially, at the correct levels. So, actually, and I'll show you, his bulb just kind of went bad. Well, not went bad.
It was loose.
Yeah. Dobby's bulb was loose, and so it just now flickered back on, and I can tell you for a fact it's good, because I just replaced it, but I'll show you. There's almost no reading, and because I just turned it on, so you can see it takes, oh, there you go, it's outputting a little bit more. You can see it slow, just going up. So just give it time and it'll be good to go. So since it takes a while for their UVB bulb to warm up, that's why it takes us about 10-15 minutes for us to, you know, check it for you. So